Hi, I'm Jared, and welcome to SUU Aviation. Today we're going to talk about the job market for A&P technicians. Let's get started. So the first sector we're going to talk about today is commercial aviation. And commercial aviation is more of a long-term career goal. And there's some positives and there's some negatives to commercial aviation. If you're looking for longevity, you want to work for a union, just a long-term solid job, commercial aviation is what you need to seek out and to go do. But there's some caveats to that. First of all, for commercial aviation, you typically can't go directly to work for a major airline. You have to go to work for a regional airline for about 3 years. Right now, most regional airlines are offering jobs to brand new A&P technicians straight out of school with a 3-year contract so that you could go get that time in. And at the end of your 3 years with the regional jets, you can move into the majors, such as Delta, American Airlines, and United. And those jobs have, right now, they are promoting very quickly, and they're moving up in the ranks very quickly. So traditionally, when it took a long time to move up in those positions, it's taking a lot less time now, and you get to make the really good money a lot faster. And there is a lot of security that comes with commercial aviation. So right now it's taking a lot less time to move up in commercial aviation. And a lot of that has to do with attrition. A large amount of the population of current workforce is retiring. Most A&P technicians are over the age of 50 right now, and the airlines are needing to backfill those positions. So they are trying to move technicians up into supervisory roles and senior roles as quick as possible and get these new technicians trained up as quickly as possible. When 5 years ago, there was a process that would take you 5 to 10 years to get to a place now where it's going to take you 2 to 3 years. So commercial aviation is going to give you your highest pay overall and most likely your best benefits. And that's because they bring you in at a fairly high wage right now. Anywhere between $40,000 to $60,000 is going to be your starting wage, depending on who you work for and where you go in the United States as an airline and as a hub. However, that will grow quickly. Right now, the majority of technicians that work for places like United and American Airlines make over $100,000 a year. And moving up into people that specialize in inspection and then have been there for a few additional years and taking on supervisory roles, that pay range goes up and up and up. And there's a lot of people in these jobs right now with places like Southwest Airlines that are making over $200,000 a year in these senior level positions. A lot of them are unionized. Well, most airlines are unionized. And if that's not what you want to go work for, that's something to take into consideration. Also, there is seniority within the unions. So you have to work your way up the ranks. You may be able to work your way up the ranks quickly, but you still have ranks that you have to work your way up. And then there's all the pros and cons that come with working for a union. There's a lot of great things that come with working for a union. It just depends on what you want to do. Now, your pros, of course, are the pay and your benefits. And a lot of times you and your family get to fly for free on that airline. There's a lot of bonuses that come with that and a lot of things that are perks in those types of jobs. You get to work on massive aircraft. You get to learn various systems, various types of aircraft, and you become very marketable very quickly within the airline industry. Another con with working for commercial airlines is a lot of times when you start off, it's shift work and it's a lot of night shift work. And that's something to be aware of as well. So your regional airlines are your stepping stone into your majors. And a lot of those regional airlines are gonna give you your first job out of A&P school. And that's companies such as SkyWest, Piedmont, and Envoy. So when I started in aviation, I started in general aviation, and I started working for a very small outfit in a very small town and kind of got my feet wet with general aviation. And then I moved into manufacturing, worked for Boeing Defense, building Apache helicopters for a number of years. And then I moved into working a different side of general aviation, which would be flight schools. And that's where you move into things like the helicopter side and you move into the fixed wing side and you get a lot of variety in a day. So my start was in general aviation and I've worked myself through several different facets of aviation, but that's generally where a lot of people start as well. So I began work with SUU's flight school as a mechanic and then moved myself into the director of maintenance for several years. And that's where I came to realize the need for technicians was growing greater and greater and greater. And the type of training that they were getting in school really wasn't cutting it. So I moved over to director of aviation maintenance training and developed the Part 147 school for SUU so that we could train technicians, license those technicians, and bring them into the industry for ourselves and for everybody else in the industry as well. SUU hosts a Part 147 training school, and what that is, it's an FAA certified school for training aircraft technicians. Our program is 18 months long, it's 5 semesters, and you end up with an associate's degree and a certificate to go work on aircraft. So another sector I want to talk about today is business aviation. Business aviation is a great place to go if you like working for a smaller company or a smaller town, smaller community. A lot of large business aviation places exist, not necessarily in the major cities, but more rural communities. And they're great jobs. They're lower pay typically. However, you get better shift work. There's a lot better community around business aviation. And you still get to work on jets that fly all over the world. They're just smaller. And within that, you also get to do a lot more in a day. You'll touch a lot more systems. You'll learn a lot more different variations of aircraft. And you'll do everything from sheet metal repairs to hydraulic repairs all in one day. So some of the cons associated with business aviation that you would find. If you're looking to go to work for a union, you really won't find those in most smaller business aviation groups. However, they're also not going to have the best benefits for the most part as compared to a commercial aviation outfit such as Delta, which is a much larger company. It's just the nature of working for a smaller company. So with business aviation also, your work-life balance is a little bit easier to manage because of the types of shifts that you're working and the way that those companies are, a lot of those companies are put together. They're more family oriented, they're more community oriented, and they are typically in smaller communities. So another big benefit of working with business aviation is they will typically hire you directly out of A&P school with no requirement that you would have in commercial aviation to go work for a regional airline first. Most companies will take you fresh out of school with a brand new A&P ticket. And a lot of schools or a lot of businesses right now are offering benefits to help pay for school. Commercial aviation is doing the same, but business aviation is also doing that where they will offer scholarships and they will offer to help pay for your testing and different things depending on what company you would like to go to work for. Some of the big business aviation companies that are looking for mechanics right now that will hire you directly out of school and that will help you pay for school and things like that is going to be Constant Aviation, Duncan Aviation, and Cutter. So SUU's AMT school is specific to helicopter training. And we do this because we love helicopters here. And there isn't another school in the country that is specific to training helicopters. We do train airplanes as well, but we emphasize a lot of our time and energy on rotor. And that's because the rotor industry needs technicians just as bad as everybody else does. But the rotor industry supports some very specific things that are important to everybody. Where your commercial aviation supports things like delivering packages and people all over the world. Well, helicopter aviation has very important functions. For instance, emergency medical is one thing that it's a very important piece of what helicopters do every day, is they transport sick people to hospitals and back. And they need technicians to work on those aircraft. Now, helicopter companies are typically smaller, and they're usually rurally located. However, they offer really good pay considering the size of the company. And their schedules and their shifts are typically amazing. A lot of companies do 7 days on, 7 days off, or 14 days on and 14 days off. You basically work half a month and get paid for the full month. And right now, helicopter companies were traditionally requiring you to have several years of rotor experience before you could come to work for them. That's starting to shift. A lot of companies are now starting to look at hiring people directly out of A&P school into the rotor industry, and that has traditionally not been heard of before. some sectors of helicopter as well that offer some really awesome things that you can do is contract work, seasonal work, tours. You can work anywhere in the world that you want to work, and there's a lot of different specialties within helicopter. You can also work for electrical companies running the electrical lines and things like that. Every single helicopter that operates in every single mission needs a technician to repair it. And that's where these jobs come in, where you can go to work in Alaska, and you can go to work in South Africa, and you can go to work anywhere a helicopter is flying. You can go do that work. And a lot of people like the idea, the flexibility and the mobility of being able to do seasonal work and contract work, which is very unique to the rotor industry. So much like business aviation, helicopter aviation is sometimes lacking on the benefits because a lot of it is seasonal work or contract work or remote. However, the pay is typically really, really good. And the culture is as well. Most people that go to work for a company typically really enjoy working for that company because they're small. You get to know everybody. It's a very family-oriented type of culture that you get with a lot of rotor operators. However, a lot of helicopter operators still don't do direct hire from A&P school, but they're starting to get there. A lot of companies are starting to do that. Now, our school offers an entire course built within the curriculum specifically to teach you about helicopters, specific systems on helicopters, how they operate, and track and balance for those helicopters as well. And these skills help make our students marketable to the rotor industry as well. So some of the major operators right now in the rotor industry that are really looking for technicians and that need them right now is PHI Helicopters, Classic Aviation, and Reach Air Medical Services. As well, you have large companies like Bristol, and these companies are always looking for technicians, and a lot of them are coming in and being willing to help pay for school. And having those conversations about that job market is very important if that's the direction you want to go, because a lot of these companies will step in, they will help you pay for school, and they will help you pay for your testing so that you can get your certificate and go to work for them. The third sector I'd like to talk about today is general aviation. General aviation is a very broad sector of aviation. It includes flight schools, mom and pop shops, and it also includes entrepreneurship, where once you have an A&P license, you can actually go out and start your own business repairing aircraft on your own. Once you have a little bit of experience and you've worked on a few aircraft, you can take that and develop your own business. You can develop your own repair station. You can develop your own service center. There are so many different avenues, especially in the entrepreneurship side, for general aviation. But a lot of general aviation you'll find is what we would call mom and pop shops. Very small places on small airports, very small companies. That typically, your pay is not going to be anywhere close than a commercial aviation outfit. However, your work-life balance is going to be amazing. You'll work a standard 8-hour shift, go home at night every day, live in the same community, do the same thing every day, work on the same style of aircraft. And if that's what interests you, then general aviation is your best avenue to go down. Most of these shops aren't going to help you pay for school or your testing or things like that. But if you're looking for very rural community and very slow paced type of job, general aviation is great for you. Now, another sector within general aviation that we have here at SUU is going to be flight school maintenance. And flight school maintenance is very different. You do get paid more, it's very high paced, and you work on a variety of different aircraft, whether that be helicopter, fixed wing, multi-engine, things like that. And there's a lot of variety working in flight schools as well. And that requires the A&P certificate, but most schools, like flight schools, aren't gonna come in and help you pay for your school like commercial aviation or business aviation would. So the one great thing about coming to an A&P school and getting your certificate is that there's a large push right now to bring women into these job markets. We just don't have a lot of women that are technicians right now, and we're trying to change that. Women in Aviation has a lot of scholarships and programs to bring women into these types of job fields, and also to educate women on how great of a career this could be, where it's typically been in the past a male-dominated field. We would like to see that become more of a 50-50. Women make great aircraft technicians. So some misconceptions that women might have about coming to work as an aircraft technician is that you need big muscles and you need to be able to turn big wrenches. or it's just a dirty job. And that's not the case anymore. Most aircraft places are very, very highly clean. They're very organized, and they need people that have attention to detail, that are organized, that can look at a system and understand it. And a lot of aircraft maintenance is that. It's understanding how systems relate to other systems and how to repair those systems. We look for brains over brawn. We can lift engines with cranes. We don't have to do it by hand. We need people that can have very tuned attention to detail and understanding systems and how those systems are organized. So that's it for this video. If you have any questions and you like this video, leave a comment down below. Smash that like button, share it with your friends. Subscribe to our channel if you're not already subscribed. Hit the notification bell so that you can stay up to date every time we upload new content. And as always, never quit, never give up, and fly it to the end. We'll be right back.